Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. I'm Akshat Bahety and today we're going to look at Perplexity's Comet. This browser is mind-blowing. Hands down, this browser is the best browser that exists right now for AI-specific experiences. I'm not going to talk about it a lot. I'm going to show you and then at the same time talk about it. So let's get started with the easiest example of this one, the LinkedIn webpage. And I'm going to ask it to very simply read this headline. OpenAI is going to launch its first office in India. So go ahead and tell me everything that people think about this move and also search for new positions that OpenAI has released. I'll show you the simplest use case that's available is that you can make a read through web pages. You come here and say, go ahead and tell me everything about what people think about this move and also search for a new position. It already knows what I'm talking about. It knows that I'm on the OpenAI office page. It's going to go ahead and research and it's going to read through this whole page. The reactions, long overdue, chance for India to benefit and everything else. This is the starting plan, a detailed impact, a research and everything else. But now the cool part would be, the next step would be, I have this information now, I can ask Comet to go ahead and actually make a post on the Jake's page. And as you'll see, Comet will now go ahead and take over the whole web page. As you can see, big blue water starts coming in and it's now going to go ahead and input a comment on Jake's page. And Jake has released, this is amazing, but let's see what the comment comes out to be. You can use Comet as a productivity assistant because the point is, again, don't use it for social media replies. They suck, like AI replies. Again, please don't use it. But let's see, like, just as an example, if you're bored and you just want to comment, you can use this. And it's going to go through it, reasoning, and it takes a couple of seconds for the assistant to go ahead and do this. Remember, guys, that it is pretty slow when you're using it because that's just how it is, but it still should not stop you from using it. Next step I want is, now I have a ton of emails, as we all do. I'm going to go ahead and ask it for the best hack in life is unsubscribe me from all the stupid newsletters that I get. Make a list, get my confirmation, and then tell me what I should unsubscribe from. I had in my email, again, there's a ton of emails, but very simply now it's going to go ahead and gather a list of all the emails. And you can also connect your Gmail and Google Calendar. So as you can see, I have the option here. I'm going to connect my email and give it access. It will get access to my email. I'm going to select all. And you can use this Perplexity connector to actually give it access to the account. And now it will be able to go ahead and do this. Not only that, you can see it's still running here. It's still going ahead and running here. And then it has this whole comment. I can click continue. It has gone ahead and written a massive comment. Now I can technically click on, you can use it to comment. This is exactly how AI native browsing should look like. You can should be able to ask questions about something and without, like, you know, needing to do anything. Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and, like, you know, very simply delete this. Again, I don't want this comment to be there, but very simply you can use it to research and everything else. Another thing that we can do with LinkedIn, you can click on this plus button here to start a new chat with the assistant. I'm going to give it another task on LinkedIn. It's find me leads which would be interested in joining an AI community that can make them 10x AI agents. I can just click on this and let's see what it does. So you can see it's going ahead and completing that. It has also identified which emails I can get rid of, like newsletter and promotional email detected. Now I can simply say unsubscribe me from everything again, and OpenAI, I need that, and Google Workspace. This will go ahead and will be able to unsubscribe to me. You can use this to do, I'll show you a quick example also on how you can. So I can say gather all my Uber receipts and tell me how much I spent. I mean, obviously I've hidden all of my legacy emails because I don't want to, but you can see, like, it can gather up all my receipts and tell me how much money I've spent across everything. It doesn't even need to take over my inbox because it has access to my inbox and can do that. And you can see it has already started unsubscribing to every email by opening each one of them. It's going in ahead and clicking on every one of them, redirecting back and seeing which can be unsubscribed from. So I can have an complete inbox which is completely free of all the junk that we get. Category promotions, and it's going to go ahead and do for each one of them. Now here to find interested leads, it's not gone ahead and done that post like this one. I'm going to say use the search box to find me leads. Use the search box to find me leads. Now it's going to take over this page and find me leads. It should not have asked the AI agent 10x productivity, and probably my prompt should have been better. But the idea is you can really tell it what you needed, what you wanted to do specifically, and focus on that. The next thing I want to do is I want you to bring to YouTube. This is probably the best and the most cool use case that you can be watching on YouTube. And I don't want to understand and watch this whole 30 minutes of video. YouTube, tell me, here's a cool feature that you can use. You can simply say, go ahead and click at, right? And say, select the tab, or even you can merge multiple tabs. I can say, tell me what is he talking about in the video in a bullet list. And now it will go ahead and watch the whole video for me, go through the whole transcript and bring me exactly what they were talking about. There are so many videos which are 1 to 2 hour long. Again, please do spend time watching videos like these. You can please subscribe if you like this kind of content. But at the same time, you can use this to just simply tell what it needs to learn. So it's talking about savings account, it's talking about low duration bonds, fixed deposit and everything else. They'll have much more details into that. You can watch the video or you can just do this. And you can utilize this for multiple things. You can see, I can see the tasks when they are done or they are being active upon. So these are the agents which are still running. You can run multiple browser level agents with Comet Assistant. And that's the idea, the way you have to think about it. It's an assistant that can do exactly what you want it to do. Now, let's say I use this. I can say very simply, big hair. And write a tweet in at X. I'm going to take this, copy this prompt here and put it in the assistant. And now it will have access to this. I've copied the prompt very simply to summarize all the content from here and write a tweet about it. And it will now be able to access both the tabs. So as you can see, it has already taken over my screen. I'm going to start ahead to write a tweet. You can use this to summarize content and utilize your research and search faster. You can utilize to technically anything that you see on the browser, you can go ahead and change that. The next step is a bit more complex one, and I like to show you how you work with this. This is Hayreach, a tool where you can run LinkedIn automation campaigns, which can DM people and everything else. I don't know how to do cold emailing or cold DMing. What we can do is you can come to campaigns, right? And I can ask it, create a new campaign for our new community, for which the details are present here. I'm going to refer to our school community. And if you're interested to learn about AI systems, go ahead and click on the link in the description and go ahead and click enter. Now, we'll go ahead and go through this whole platform and start creating a new campaign. It's going to create a new campaign, take over all of this. This is how you need to use Comet. The point is, it can do so much for you. You just need to find ideas on how you connect these things. The best part is that it gives me, like, you know, again, this whole actual AI feel. Like, again, I don't have to, like, you know, again, AI mostly is right now still very text based, right? Like, except the agent mode in OpenAI. This mostly feel like, you know, okay, I just have to keep doing this myself. I have to go ahead and figure it out. I have to go ahead and pick this thing. So, right, again, it's just my right now. If you see it, it's gone ahead, connected. My account was connected here, and it can take over and do this and create a whole sequence campaign. This feels like magic. I'm sitting here talking to you guys about this, and this is what's happening. And you're missing out on a massive amount of power that is there. As you can see, it has access to a couple of things. It's going to go ahead, create messages, create a workflow that I need. I don't even need to stay on this tab. I can just move on to another tab. And as you can see, it started writing a tweet for me. It has written a tweet for me, and I can click continue and it'll go ahead and post that tweet for me. I am gone through multiple levels of tasks. It will go ahead, post it for me. I'm going to delete it. It has going ahead and doing so many things. It has also gone through multiple posts of people on how to 10x their productivity and XYZ. Technically, we would have wanted people who are not talking about AI because those are the people who actually need help. It has figured out, clicks, got all of their posts here, created also the top LinkedIn profiles that we can look into. And it's still going ahead and unsubscribing everything here. So it has unsubscribed. Okay, perfect. It's already unsubscribed everything. Are you done? And I can ask it that, and it can keep taking over. The idea that I'm going ahead and moving through a process, it already created a system, right? It's already going ahead and creating another more detailed campaign, I believe, if it needs to, and configuring it. I'm going to let it continue, but I'm going to show you a cool trick in the place. So this is Canva, right? I'm going to ask it very simply to create a new product launch announcement in red tones. And here is how you should prompt it. Okay, first tell it what you need, task, right? And then the next thing you should tell is very simply tell it about the content. Content, keep it a couple of sentences, and you can click on the position button to select layers and then use the layers to edit them. Try not to add new text boxes. Get started on this, it will deep dive on that. And here we also have the sequence created and it's ready to go. And I can just click on continue and launch the campaign. So obviously there will be some issues, But it has the tweet also here ready. I can click on post and it will post it. Like again, I did not need to do anything. I was just like, you know, again, clicking and adding this completely. Like I did not need to do anything. I just literally clicked on this and went through with it. It's going to create something. This quite literally blows the mind. Now, here is my YouTube analytics. I can ask it, how can I grow the channel more? And what are three things that I need to change? What are three key things that I need to change? Now, it has access to my analytics. It has access to the page. It will go ahead and research everything and give me an answer based on what it believes would be a right path. Now, if you can come here, it's actually created something. I don't know how good or bad it looks, right? Introducing our innovations. Not perfect with the design thing because it wrote something pretty cool, big. But given that it was able to, I believe, pick up a template and bring all of this back, you can also use this. It's just that I'm going to zoom in a bit so you can see the text. Introducing our newest innovation. We did not give it how many lines or what do we want to write. Wrote two times. It's bound to make mistakes. That's okay. But given that it was able to create a design without us needing to do anything by choosing a template and just adding text, you can imagine how better it will get. This is the first step and how better it will keep getting from here. That's the beauty of Comet. Now, I'm going to bring you here. It has gone ahead and analyzed content on what can be there. And you can see some of them have CTR of 11%, yes, and some of them don't. So I want more click-through rates because packaging is super important in video. I can go through this and like, you know, have a whole discussion with it on my data. That's the beauty of using Perplexity. I have made it my default browser. I need to use anything else other than this from any kind of work. You have the AI assistant right there with you. You can ask it to do so much more. And this is just like scratching the surface. I've made it make workflow diagrams. I made it make images. I made it take complete research reports and take them down. And it works quite literally 80% there. Not flawless, but 80% there. If you want to keep learning how to utilize these products more and how to increase your productivity with AI, go ahead and click on that subscribe button. With that, I would love to see you in the next one. Bye-bye.